Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMi RPG sample video. I know it's an old format, but I'm sure you'll still have to use XML format files. To read these files, we have several options from RPG. We can use xml-into and more recently data-into, but of course we can also use SQL to import and read these files. Today I show you a small example of how to easily import and read these files with SQL. Let's go! Well, this is the XML file that I have prepared for the example. Of course, it is in the IFS. As you see, it is a very simple file with customer data. Well, we are going to try to import this information from an RPG program. For doing this, the first thing we are going to do is to create a table with SQL. And for that, let's go to the Run SQL Script utility. Okay, we are going to create a table as follows. Create or replace table. This is going to be the name of the table. And in this case, we are going to have only one field, field one, that it is going to be of type XML. Okay, if we run this, it is done. And well, let me also add this table to be generalized. Okay, this is not needed if your system is automatically generalized every created table. Okay, well, now let's go again to VS Code, where I'm gonna create a new program. Okay, the program will first of all read the XML file into this table, and after that we will read the content into a data structure in our program. Okay, you will see it is very easy. Well, first of all, I'm going to create a template in my program, but you can create the data structure directly. Okay, customer T qualified template. And I'm going to put here the same structure that a customer has, okay? That's why I have put it XML here, okay? So I will have a number. It's gonna be this type. Date. Well, now let me write the main procedure. Now I'm going to declare the structure where I'm going to store the data. Customer, that is going to be like the S, customer T. Okay, this way. Well, now I'm going to declare a few variables that I'm going to use for loading the XML file. This is gonna be a club file that is an SQL type, okay. I will need a path where the file is stored. Okay. And well, first of all, I'm going to load the XML file into the table. So I do it this way. I'm going to clear the file, the XML file. And I'm going to put a name. Well, path. The length of the name. Now using SQL, I can insert the completely the XML file into my table just using an insert this way. Values. Okay. It's as simple as this. Well, let's see how can we read the content of my table. For that, first thing I am going to do is to clear the customer structure, and I'm going to declare a cursor like this. Or I will need XML table for parsing the XML this way. Table, for example, document. Let me move this. Okay, this is because I'm going to read a XML document with this path. Okay, customers, customer, customers, customer. And this is gonna be passing B field 1 as XML document columns. And the columns are gonna be the different fields of the XML, okay? Number, numeric, 3, 5, path, and I only need to close the XML table and put it a name, A. Okay, so I'm selecting everything from A, that is this, from the table, that is B, okay, and I'm using XML table this way, okay. Well, the rest of the program is very easy because I only have to read a cursor. Okay, so I'm going to open it. Close it. And I'm going to fetch the cursor. Max rows into customer. Okay, I need to declare max rows. Okay, and this way I am reading the XML file and I am putting the content inside the customer structure. Okay. And for knowing how many rows I have readed, I use getDiagnostics this way. Okay. Rows 4. I think it is all done. Let me see. So let me try to compile program. Okay, just compile. So now let's see how it works on the green screen. Okay, let me start a debug session. Let me stop the program here and let me run the program. Well, the first thing I'm doing is inserting inside the table the content of the XML file. So if I run this statement, that is what I have done. So let me see if it has been done. Let me see the content of the file. Well, as you see, I have the content inside the file. I have the XML file. Okay, let me continue the program. I'm opening the cursor and fetching into customer structure. Okay, so let me see. And as you can see, the content of the XML file is inside my structure. Okay, so if I see how many rows I have readed, the rows are only one. Why only one? Because the XML is just one XML. Let me try it again, because I want you to see something. As you can see, if I see my XML, the first customer has customer number, name, date, address, and country, but the second customer has no country. Okay, what has happened with this? Well, as you see, the first customer has all the information, and the second has everything but the country. Okay, so it works correctly even if you have some field missing. Okay, so it runs perfectly. Well, as you see, it is very easy to use XML files using SQL. We can easily store them using SQL in a table and also parse them in a very simple way. I hope it has been useful to you. As always, click like if you like the video, and don't forget to subscribe. As always, thanks for watching.